Hi friends, so again absent for a few days. So I was just going through budget and survey in detail because we are going to start an online class for that. So one interesting phenomena the survey mentions is about dramatic, within quote, dramatic increase in India's rank in the Corruption Perception Index, which is given annually by a global NGO, Transparency International, which is based in Berlin. So we'll see what, whether it is a dramatic improvement or not a bit later. What is this index? This index measures corruption only in the public sector, public institution, in government and associated organizations. Like in India, we can talk about the PSUs and the stuff like that, local bodies. The corruption, of course, is done by private individuals with the connivance, with the help, unholy help of people in power, both bureaucrats and politicians included. Some favors they get. India's rank this year, the report has come for 2019 report has been published in January end, hardly 15 days back. Rank is 80 out of 180 countries, which is actually a fall of 2 from last year, 78. This particular index calculates the score, a raw score, which is based on 16 different types of sample surveys done for different people in every country, 180 countries, and also inputs taken from 12 organizations. Some organizations are internationally renowned, like World Bank, World Economic Forum, etc. Some of them are unheard of American organizations like Freedom House, Global Watch, etc. So naturally, the rank of China, Russia, etc. will be lower because inputs are also taken from so-called global organizations based in US. But it is based on surveys also what people think, perceive about the level of corruption in their country. The report has been given since 1995, so long time. So it has been last 25 years, we have been collecting, getting the data. Now we'll see the story a little bit more in depth. When it started, India's rank was the best in the very first year, 35. 1995, India's rank was 35. And for the next 2 years, it was in the 40s, 96 and 97. Then of course, we had a big change, and for the first time BJP came to power, Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who was the Prime Minister till 2003. From 97, from the 40s, it jumped to 80s. And since then, it has been maintaining in the 80s. Our good economic survey, which is nothing but a political tool, these days hardly any economic data is there, all blah 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 blah. After almost 30 years of economic liberalization, they are singing the price of economic liberalization as if this is not known to the people, without talking about the problems of present day India and what are the solutions for that. So you cannot take selectively and say that there is an improvement. Yes, the lowest thing was 2011, when India's rank became 95. And within 2012 and 13 also, it has reduced. 2011, it was due to all the CAA report on, CAG report on, this CAA thing never leaves your mind at all. So you get infatuated with that after some time. CAG report on coal scam, 2G scam, all that. And of course, coinciding with the Anna Hazare movement in Delhi, which propelled Mr. Arvind Kejriwal to national prominence. After that also, it has been reducing. But you have not yet come out of that 80s wala thing, which have been struck still from 1998 onwards. So there's no dramatic improvement as, because they don't want, they just, you know, they don't give the data. India's score is 41. The score, I will briefly tell, based on the surveys and the reports, the total maximum score a country can get is 100 and the lowest is 0. As usual, the Scandinavian and Western European countries are doing very well. Denmark and New Zealand are occupying the topmost lot, 87 points out of 100. So no country can say that they are completely corruption free as perceived by their own people. But to a large extent, the Western European countries are very good. Sweden and Finland are also in the top 10. A big drop has been seen in Australia, but still it has a very high score of 77. The reason is, I will come back and tell. They are also giving, the Somalia is the worst country with a score of 9. India's score is 41. Our best score is 87, so not even half of that. Right. They are ranking regions also. Best region is, of course, Western Europe, with around score of 77 something. Lowest is Sub-Saharan Africa, around 32-35. The region which India is, Asia Pacific, has an average score of 45. So whereas India score is 41. So India's score, though dramatically improved as claimed by the economic survey, is still lower than our peer countries in Asia Pacific. And Australia, they have specifically mentioned the name of India and Australia in the CS report. They say in both these countries, their rank has gone down because of infusion of private, undisclosed, corrupt money into the electoral politics. So that is why they say it's a big threat to democracy itself. That has happened because of the amendments made in 2017 regarding corporate financing of elections to political parties in India. In the name of promoting transparency, where it has completely gone against transparency, now corporates can buy electoral bonds from the banks without, nobody knows except the bank, which will share it with the RBI, and RBI will share it with the powers that be. They can buy the bonds and donate it to any political party. They can send it. The political party can claim that it does not know who has given the money to them. And the corporate also need not have to disclose this information to their own stakeholders, shareholders. Transparency. This is called transparency. So, because of this enormous amount of black money, need not be black money, but enormous amount of corporate money comes particularly to the ruling party. And that is the reason India's rank is going down. Same thing is happening in Australia also, because there also this is what called crony capitalism. And once they give the money, the report also say that they get enormous amount of influence in the decision making process, and the important decisions will be taken by the government only to facilitate them. That is the reason no big industrial group has emerged in India, even though survey talks a lot about trust and pro-business approach rather than pro-crony approach. Just ask them to show me only one corporate group which has come up in India in the last 25 years. They can show one group which name starts with A and ends with I, from Gujarat, Adani. But we know what connections that group has got. So in reality, no hardworking, honest entrepreneurs can come up in India. because of this entrenched crony capitalism, which is now increased by making it completely opaque, the donations, corporate donations to political parties. So this is one of the major reasons why India's rank is same place. It is not improving, or in fact it has gone down also. So unless and until we clean up the electoral system, there cannot be any development or economic growth for India, because we are mired into caught up in a quagmire, or dal-dal in Hindi, so called crony capitalism. And that is the reason why corporate taxes are also reduced to favor them, because they are given enormous amount of money to finance the elections. So it is essentially democracy is at peril because of behind the scenes maneuvering by these big corporate groups, and we don't even know how much they have given officially. Also unofficially, black money is given, cash is given to the political parties, which they spend on bribing the voters directly, whereas this is officially white money is transferred by buying electoral bonds, which will finance the white activities of political parties like campaigning in media, travel expenses of their leaders, etc. So both operate at the same time. So this is the biggest problem facing India. Unless and until we tackle this corruption at the high places, there is no way India can develop.